So, you want to start designing your first real game, your first commercial project? Well, I'm here to help. I've been making games for the last 7 years, and for the last 3 years, I've been focusing on a pretty big indie project that I've been undertaking alone, and I'm here to tell you about some tips and some lessons that I've learned over these years of indie game development. So let's jump right in. What's up, everybody? My name is Anas. Welcome back to The Hive, the place where we make awesome games one cell at a time. On this channel, we learn how to make big games alone or in small teams. We learn how to leverage tools, technologies to help us along the way. And before we jump into the tips, we need to talk about this video's sponsor, Core. Core is a new, fully featured gaming platform where you can create, publish, monetize, and play games all in one place and all for free. It is based on Unreal Engine, which makes it insanely powerful with high-quality AAA graphics. And they did a great job of abstracting most of Unreal's complexity to make it basically the easiest game creation platform I've ever used. You can create entire games without writing a line of code, and if, however, you know how to code, you can create your own game logic in Lua. Core offers thousands of free music, sound, and art assets you can use in your own games. There are many advanced templates you can start from with a lot of built-in functionality, and you can also reimagine other creators' games and make them your own. Once you finish your game, you can monetize it and publish it instantly for others to play since Core has built-in multiplayer. And the 50% revenue share is pretty much the best you'll get in the industry as of today. With the help of the Perks program, some Core creators have been able to pay their bills, buy their dream cars, and quit their day jobs. Long story short, Core is undeniably the easiest way to get into game development today, so click the link in the description, download Core for free, play some games, and start creating your own awesome game. And now let's get into the tips. Let's get into how to design your first real complex game. Starting with tip number one, design a game you like to play. This might seem like something that is obvious, but a lot of aspiring game developers will try to push away their inspiring idea and their best idea, trying to keep it for the second or the third project, thinking that it's going to be too hard to make. But the thing is, when you're making a commercial project, game dev is pretty much 40 or 50% of the time you're going to be spending on that project. So the game itself is just part of the adventure, and there are so many things that you need to take care of besides game dev. So when you are designing your first game, really go for the idea that you want to make, unless it is something like an MMO with thousands of hours and you want to make that alone, which is pretty much going to be impossible. But other than that, if you are a fan of first person shooters, go for a first person shooter. If you are a fan of RTS, maybe go for an RTS project. Really go for a game that you will like to play. The reason for this is that you will experience project fatigue, you will get exhausted from your project, and at that moment, if your game isn't something that you are really passionate about, it will be really easy for you to abandon that project. If you want to stay motivated, really work on something that you are enjoying and that you will want to play once it is finished, because in the worst moments of your project, it is what is going to keep you motivated and keep you productive. All right, on to tip number two, design around your strengths. So what this means is design a game that will mostly require the skills that you have. If you are a programmer, maybe design a visually very simple game, but that has some complex and interesting mechanics. If you are an artist, maybe design a poetic game that is based around exploration and puzzles, or something that doesn't require too much programming and too much code and too much systems. Really figure out, if you are alone, figure out what your best skills are. If you are in a team, figure out what are your core skills and try to design your game using those constraints. This will make you comfortable during the development of the project. It will give you confidence to really advance at a good rate. It will lower the risk for your project, lower the risk of hitting some blockades that you cannot get over. So really, this is an important tip, designed around your strengths and designed using the constraints of your skills. Okay, tip number three is design in steps. When I say design in steps, I do not mean just design with milestones. Of course, milestones are important. Milestones are completely necessary for a project to keep advancing at a good rate and to really have a vision and see where you are going. But what I mean when I say design your game in steps, it means have those milestones be as close to a complete game as possible. So let's say, for example, you're making an action adventure game with combat and a variety of enemies and many maps. Really design your game in a way that at every milestone you have almost a complete game. The reason for this is that, as for the first tip, you will never know when you will get exhausted from your project. You will never know if you will need funding to complete your project. And at those moments, if you get exhausted, if you find out that it is impossible for you to finish that project alone and that you need funding, it is really important that you have something that is as close to a finished version as possible so that you can use it to seek funding, you can use it for Kickstarter, you can use it to maybe even finish and ship your game, even if it's not the complete vision. But if you are close to a finished product, it could require maybe months to finish it. But if you are exhausted from your project and you do not want to let all the time that you worked on that project go to waste, if you are close to something that is finished, you will have enough energy and motivation to finish it. But if you are just like building a lot of systems at the same time and you have nothing that is close to a finished project, it will be as well very easy for you to abandon that project. Okay, tip number four, go for something that works. This is very, very important, especially if you are going to spend years working on a project. If you are going to commit to making a commercial indie game, go for a genre that works. Go for something that has an audience. Don't go for something completely original. It can be absolutely amazing and fascinating to work on something like that, but if this is your life project and if you are relying on the success of this project to be able to continue making video games and indie games, go for something that works when you're starting your first commercial project. You can after that move to some things that are more original and more creative, but for your first project, try to stick to something that works, that has an audience, to ensure some success and really put you in a comfortable position to then take more risks with the upcoming project. If, however, you really want to make something that is original and completely out of the box, the step that we talked about before, designing steps, becomes even more important. In order to really prove that your idea works, you need to design a very simple, very small prototype or almost finished game to test that idea, because sometimes ideas can seem absolutely amazing in our mind when we have them and when we just like run them through our mindful gameplay systems, and the ideas could seem really genius and absolutely amazing, and then once you prototype them and you have your gamepad in hand or your mouse and keyboard, you just figure out that it doesn't work, that it breaks the flow of your game, that it doesn't go with the rhythm of your game or something like that. So if you are really into the mood of creating something that is completely original, completely out of the box, start really small. Don't build the entire game. Just build the tiny version of it. Make it as complete as possible and try to have people playtest it and give you feedback. And if that works, then you will be more comfortable going forward. But if you have a completely original idea and you just dive in and start making the entire game, you could figure out like years afterwards that your idea doesn't work. Like it seems good on paper in theory, but in practice it just doesn't work, and that could be a lot of waste of time. And my last and final tip is, do not wait for the perfect idea. I cannot stress this enough, but this is absolutely necessary to keep in mind, because so many game developers, and myself included, we waste so much time just sitting on a couch and trying to think of the perfect idea. But there's something really weird about ideas, is that they do not come when you think of them. It might seem counterintuitive, but actually the best ideas come when you're absolutely not thinking of them. So what I want you to do for this is figure out the genre of the game that you want to make. Just start making that game. You have so many things you need to build before you get to those original and like really nice ideas. But whilst you will be working on that game, whilst you will be building the base systems and the controller and the levels and the enemy AI, you will be flooded with ideas. They will just rain on you. You will not know what to do with ideas, but you need to be working for ideas to come. Ideas do not come when you think of them. Ideas come when you are thinking of something else and working on something else, and then you just have a bug, what we call happy accident. Maybe you have a dash button and you click that button and you hold it, and then your character is flying, and you just get like these crazy happy accidents that happen sometime and that completely redesign your games. So if you are waiting for the perfect idea, you are doing it wrong. Start making your game and the perfect idea will come sooner or later. Don't worry about that. And that's it guys for this short video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you liked it. I will be doing two more videos which are follow-ups to this. I will be talking about how to work efficiently on your game as a solo developer or in a small team. And we will be talking about how to finish and ship your game. Those are two very distinct and very important parts of game development. I hope that these videos will be useful to you. I hope that sharing my experience is going to help you. Don't forget to check out Core. The link is in the description. It's completely free and you will not regret discovering it. It's really an amazing tool. Also, if you've enjoyed this video, please don't forget to hit that like button and hit that subscribe button, as well as that notify bell. And as always, my name is Anas. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.